Hi, I'm Tom Petersen, and welcome to Architecture All Access Season 3, Episode 3, Meteor Lake Graphics. I'm a fellow at Intel, and I hold a BS and MS in electrical engineering, as well as an MBA and an SCPD certificate from Stanford in AI. I've been working in GPUs for the last 20 years of my life, and in the last 5 years, building Intel's new discrete GPU family, Arc. Meteor Lake was built with three goals in mind. First, power efficiency to enable long battery life. Second, enable AI at scale in the PC for new experiences. And third, deliver a leap in graphics performance. Let's talk about graphics, which is important for four major experiences on a PC. Media consumption, like playing a video, content creation, for example, like video editing, of course, gaming, and finally, productivity, like video collaboration. There are over 3 billion gamers worldwide, which is an increase of over 1 billion from 2015. And half of those gamers are on a PC. And of those gamers, 40% are on laptops. Content creation is also exploding, increasing from 145 million creators in 2020 to 300 million today. All of this means we need GPU horsepower like never before. Now let's dig into the GPU IP, which is grouped into three logical blocks. First, the display engine. Second, the media engine. And lastly, the graphics engine. In a traditional design, the GPU IP is all integrated into a single die, but Meteor Lake is different. Tim talked about how we repartitioned Meteor Lake and how it is constructed from four separate silicon tiles. This helps us achieve our efficiency goals, since we can spread the GPU IP across different tiles, which means we can control power for each block independently. We can also select the best silicon technology for each block. On Meteor Lake, the media engine is in the SoC tile, which means that during video playback, we can keep the CPU tile and the graphics tile powered down to save power. We use a dedicated tile for the graphics, compute, and AI logic, which means we can pick the right silicon technology for the best trade-off between performance and power. Over the last several generations, we've been rapidly pushing up the performance of integrated graphics. We doubled the performance from Gen 9 to Gen 11, and again from Gen 11 to XeLP, which is used in our Alder Lake CPU. And for Meteor Lake, we're doing it again, doubling performance moving from XeLP to XeLPG. XeLPG is not just about delivering higher performance, though. We also are improving power efficiency and delivering a modern feature set. To improve performance, our architects leveraged three different vectors: higher clock frequency, better architectural efficiency, and increased GPU size. Or simply said, we made it faster, so the processing is quicker. We made it better, so we can do denser calculations. And bigger, so that we can get more done at the same time. Now let's dive into clock frequency improvements. For more detail on how processors control clock frequency, tune into episode 2 of Architecture All Access Season 1, where we deep dive into chip frequency. To improve the clock frequency on Meteor Lake's GPU, we used newer transistor technology, which makes everything faster, and we re-implemented our design optimizing for speed. We also used AI for the first time to reduce routing delays and optimize the overall placement. The result is both a faster GPU when running at high performance for demanding workloads and reduced voltage and power when running light workloads. Beyond making XeLPG run faster, we improved the architectural efficiency further, pulling in technology from our XeHPG architecture. GPUs are complex engines with a mix of programmable compute and dedicated functions required to render images. So let's deep dive. At the lowest level, the Xe vector engine is where compute operations take place. It's configured similarly in XeHPG and XeLPG with a 256-bit wide vector architecture. The vector engine can process typically FP32 and FP16 instructions used in graphics. It's also capable of executing integer instructions concurrently and supports DP4A for fast AI inferencing. Vector engines are grouped together to form the foundational and scalable compute block of our GPUs, the Xe core. For XeLPG, the Xe core is optimized for efficiency and configured with 16 vector engines. It leverages a new cache architecture with 192 kilobytes split between an L1 cache for more efficient memory accesses and a shared memory for data sharing between threads. To assist the Xe cores and deliver great real-time rendering performance, some dedicated fixed function hardware is required. This includes the geometry pipeline, the rasterizer, and an optimization block called HiZ, which allows us to quickly cull hidden pixels. The Xe LPG also includes samplers for reading and filtering textures, and pixel backends to write, blend, and compress pixels in the frame buffer. To make the new rendering techniques and better visual experiences more accessible, we've integrated ray tracing units for the first time in our built-in GPU. DirectX 12 Ultimate is the API standard for PC games and advanced graphics, and I'm happy to say that the Xe LPG GPU has been fully optimized for this API, helping developers target a common feature set across discrete and integrated GPUs. I've talked about clock frequency, talked about efficiency. Now let's have a look at how we've created a bigger GPU. As a baseline, let's start with the GPU that was inside our previous generation. It came with six groups of 16 execution units, the predecessor of our Xe Vector engine. As a first step, we've replaced those six EU groups with our latest Xe cores. Then we added two more Xe cores and the extra samplers and pixel backends to fully support them. When designing the architecture and doing performance modeling, we found out that the geometry pipeline and supporting functions has a big impact on performance. That's why we've doubled those functions for Meteor Lake's GPU. To do that, we've implemented a second render slice in the design, and we've reorganized compute resources optimally between them. The last architectural addition is dedicated hardware for accelerated ray tracing. The resulting GPU architecture is significantly bigger than our previous engine found in Alder Lake. It's 8 Xe cores, 128 vector engines, 8 samplers with 64 textiles per clock, 4 pixel backends with 32 pixels per clock, 2 render slices with 2 times the geometry throughput, and 8 ray tracing units. This GPU configuration, combined with higher clocks and improved architectural efficiency, delivers the 2x perf we set as our goal. Hardware is only half of the story when it comes to GPUs. If you've followed me on our Arc Discrete journey, you probably know that we've put a ton of work into our improved Arc software stack and our day zero game support. All of these benefits will come to Meteor Lake with built-in Arc graphics. This includes XeSS, our AI-based upscaling technology. XeSS allows the GPU to render high-quality images in games with higher performance. XeSS leverages an AI supersampling engine accelerated by DP4A and a frame history to upscale a low-resolution image to a high-resolution output image. Meteor Lake's GPU combined with XeSS will make more games playable in smaller form factors. All these architectural capabilities allow Meteor Lake to deliver a leap in graphics performance and a modern graphics feature set with emphasis on power efficiency. Meteor Lake is our largest shift in client SoC architecture in 40 years. Thank you for joining today in Architecture All Access Meteor Lake Graphics. Please stay tuned for an upcoming episode on AI acceleration in Meteor Lake, and thanks for tuning in.